Welcome to the 2021 Tigerpalooza Kickoff Assembly.
We are so excited to kick off today. Even if it is virtual, we cannot wait to introduce our recipient and to hear about where the non-perishable items we collect will go.
We will also compete to win points for the class competition. At each assembly, we will play a game, and if your grade wins the game, you get a point.
Our game today will be Jenga.
All right, so today we've got a very highly skilled competition here, a little Jenga, seniors, juniors, and sophomores. Freshmen starting it off for us. Let's see what we got here. Sophomores going next. A little easy grab off the bottom. Things are sliding out easy first. Takes another easy one. Another good grab. Another easy grab for the seniors. At least that's what it looks like. Yep, easy grab. Ah! And the freshman makes the tower fall in the first round. All right, due to a lack of time, we will only be playing one more round. The final two competitors standing will both get a point for their class. Let's get it started. Done pretty quickly. Juniors. It seems that our competitors here have messed up the order. I don't know how they did that, but I'm just gonna keep letting them play at this point. We're trying to go back to the bottom of the tower for the next walk. Noticing some changes mind. Trying to take from the middle now. Gets that one easily. Here. He does not know which block he wants to take. And he seems to have found one now. Alrighty, makes a fairly. Senior seems to be making a plan here. Executed perfectly. Sophomore's making another easy grab. Slow. Seniors make another easy grab from our fourth row. Our senior's getting a little nervous here. He slowly but surely gets the block out. He doesn't know if he can do this. Oh! And he pulls it out with speed. He definitely deserves all the praise in this competition. Getting nervous. Whoa. Sliding it out of there very slowly. Tries to smack it out of there, it didn't seem to work. It seems that that smack worked in his favor. It seems that the smack worked in his favor. I don't really know how, but he's... Seems like this will be the loser. Ah! This will be the loser. Ah! And our junior makes the tower fall.
We
Without further ado, our 2021 Tigerpalooza recipient is the Regional Food Bank of Oklahoma.
To tell us about our recipient, here is Cassie Gilman, the Executive Director of the Regional Food Bank of Oklahoma.
Hi, Norman Tigers. My name is Cassie Gilman, and I'm the Chief Development Officer at the Regional Food Bank of Oklahoma. Like you, Norman, Oklahoma is my home. And so this year, I was thrilled to learn that your Tigerpalooza will benefit the Regional Food Bank. Better yet, because of our partnership with NHS Pantry, your Tigerpalooza is going to stay right here in our community and at your high school to help children and families who are food insecure. Did you know that 1 in 4 kids in our state are food insecure? So just think about that for a second. Think about 4 or 5 of your closest friends, and the likelihood that one of them is food insecure is pretty high. So I'm so excited that you're going to raise money and funds and food to stock your own pantry, because it's going to help people in our community. Thank you for your support. Good luck with your fundraising. We are so excited. I know you hear it every year that you want to make this the best Tigerpalooza ever, but why not? It's been a crazy year with COVID. We're working virtually. We're going to school virtually. We're going to school sometimes. And there are so many more of our neighbors that need your help. So let's make this the best year ever. Go Tigers!
Thank you, Ms. Gilman. We're so excited to be partnering with the Regional Food Bank of Oklahoma.
We will be having a class competition with collecting non-perishable items as well. In our first hours, we will be collecting non-perishables starting Monday, March 1st, and go throughout the season.
We will have collections in first hours. The last day of can collection, we will have a game to see who can make the biggest hour out of items they have collected.
Next, we will be talking to where all of our non-perishable items that your grade collects will go. Norman High's own food pantry.
The title of my position is community liaison. And the short version of the long story is when I took this job 12 years ago now, I was asked to set up a food pantry for students that from time to time might be in food insecure or who just are all the time. And the basic idea is while my kid is sitting in calculus, learning calculus, it's not fair for another kid to be sitting there and they can't concentrate on calculus because they don't know where their next meal's coming from. Or, well, in a normal year, we send food bags home. We're like 52% free and reduced lunch at Norman High School. So in a regular non-COVID year, we send food bags home every Friday. Because of the problem with getting volunteers and all into the building this year, we're working out of a remote food pantry, so we're sending a big box of food home once a month. So in answer to your question, we try to, with shelf-stable foods, we don't have a way to refrigerate or freeze anything. So we know that canned foods and all are not the very most healthy, but we try to get a balance in there of proteins and all. So the main things that we look for are canned vegetables, fruits. Sorry, I made a list. I have to look at it. Individual servings like of mac and cheese or fruit or whatever. Pop tops are really good because not everybody has a can opener. That's something to keep in mind. Jerky, like beef jerky, Slim Jims, things like that are huge treats for kids, and it's a pretty good source of protein. But basically, if you're a teenager and it's something you would like to eat, those would be good things to contribute.
Thank you, Ms. Wilkins.
We see this year as a year of change, starting with our own school, and what better way can we do that than giving back to our own student body?
Thank you so much for joining us virtually.
Make sure to go to Earth Roots on Saturday and mention Tigerpalooza for 15% towards TPAL, and The Fix on Thursday, March 5th, for 20% towards Tigerpalooza.
Sign-ups for Powder Puff will be out next week. Also, get ready for the games assembly and class competitions.
Remember to come by room 513 for your Tigerpalooza merch. Hoodies are $30 and t-shirts are $20. We take cash, card, and checks.
Go T-Pal!